a lot of great memories. And
good joke, you know.
Best entertainer in the world, and best entertainment is probably dressing room number three.
Yes.
Yep. And, I love to pick at him and aggravate him and
I like him.
Get him going.
And he had a good sense of humor.
Oh yeah, oh, amazing.
He did not always have to be telling the joke. Yeah. He didn't get upset if you pulled a joke and the joke was on him.
Yeah.
He would laugh just as hard at himself as he would at a joke that he told.
And he's always looking for new material.
Always.
You know, one thing about it, when you was with him, you were all like family.
Yeah.
With him and with Mona and Mona Lisa.
Get ready to leave, go out on the road at night, and he'd have his little care package of food that Mona had cooked. I always like to have the first shift out driving at night, because we'd sit there and eat all the food. I guarantee you, if you paid attention, you could learn something every time you stepped on stage with him.
Yeah.
He was just an entertainer, His passing definitely has closed the door on that era of entertainment. There's not any. I love all of country music that's going on today, but there's nobody standing. He was the last guy standing. There are no more great country entertainers.
I agree.
And sadly, a lot that are out there now did not have the luxury that we had to work with a lot of the greats. You know, Tom worked with Leroy Van Dyke.
And they really entertained.
They entertained.
Great entertainers.
Wasn't Jimmy was just a great singer, which he really was, if you listen to his old ballads.
But
it didn't matter if it was 3 o'clock in the morning and you were at some 7-Eleven getting gas in the van and somebody pecked on the window and he would get up and screw that hat on his head and pose for a picture. He never once turned away a fan. And I like to leave the thought that first he was my boss, and then for a lot of years he was my mentor, and last but not least he was my friend. And he'll always be missed in my heart.